you want to get into data science but don't want to shell out lots of money for expensive courses, then you've come to the right place. Today, I'll talk exclusively about the best free online resources to learn data science. I'll cover resources across four categories: coding tools, Python, statistics and maths for machine learning, and finally, machine learning algorithms. This is a bottom-up approach to learning data science. Let's talk about coding tools. There's a very good reason why I'm covering this before I get to any machine learning stuff. As a data scientist, you'll spend a majority of your day on the computer in the terminal. More often than not, you'll need a good grasp of basic coding practices, like using Git, command line, debugging and profiling your code, shell scripting, and basic data wrangling. A few months ago, I found an amazing online course called The Missing Semester by MIT. This is a free online course that aims to teach students everything they should have learned in their computer science degrees. This course teaches you the most practical skills that you're guaranteed to use daily as a data science practitioner. I know all too many data scientists that initially struggle a lot with basic coding tools, despite knowing the latest about machine learning algorithms. Next up is Python. Python is the most commonly used programming language by data scientists. It's used for data wrangling, data cleaning, data exploration analysis, and implementing machine learning algorithms. You should approach learning Python in three steps. The first step is to learn Python syntax, which will expose you to coding if you've never done it before, and teach you the basics of the language. As if you're learning nouns, verbs, and how to create sentences as though you were learning to speak English or any other language. A great place to get started is the Python website. They've kindly curated a whole list of great beginner tutorials for Python. And if you prefer to learn more interactively with do-it-yourself exercises, I would recommend learnpython.org. They not only cover all the basics of the language, but also NumPy and Pandas, packages that are basically the bread and butter of the data science world. The second step is to learn problem solving using Python. HackerRank and LeetCode are excellent platforms to start solving toy problems. They'll expose you to a wide array of coding problems and get you thinking in an application-focused manner. Because at the end of the day, what good is learning Python syntax if you can't use it to solve problems? The final step in learning Python is to create your own pet project. And you can easily get started simply by Googling pet projects for Python. A while ago, one of my pet projects using Python was to create a home loan repayment calculator and visualizer. But you can pick any problem that you're passionate about. Some examples of a pet project include building a weather app, a snakes and ladders game, or an interactive dashboard displaying your personal finances. Now that you know how to learn Python, let's talk about statistics. The best place to get started is Khan Academy. This course about statistics and probabilities will teach you everything you need to know about data distributions, confidence intervals, hypothesis testing, regression, and many more basics. I can't recommend it highly enough, as I often use it to refresh my stats knowledge. Moving on to maths for machine learning. One of the best courses I've found is the machine learning specialization on Coursera. It's divided up into three specializations, the first being linear algebra, the second being multivariate calculus, and the third being principal component analysis. I'd highly recommend the first two, and you can get to the third one when you move on to learning more about machine learning algorithms. Finally, let's talk about machine learning algorithms. I've previously recommended the Stanford course for machine learning on Coursera, and I still think this is one of the best places to get started. But recently I noticed that Kaggle has a good range of intro courses in ML. I would also recommend you to try those out, and then following that, you can start competing in Kaggle competitions just for the sake of learning. Because I found Kaggle to have a great collaborative atmosphere where users are more than happy to share their solutions to a given problems for the sake of learning. And if you're interested in learning more about deep learning, a subset of machine learning that's getting a lot of attention in the media, I can't recommend this book highly enough. This is the absolute Bible for learning more about deep learning. Recently, I've also been going through this book, which is Hands-on Machine Learning with Scikit-learn and TensorFlow, which is an awesome applications-focused book. That wraps up this video. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.